Now that we have the ability to create jobs, we're going to shift our attention to the job search and the job display pages. The core features of this section revolve around repeating groups to display our job lists, filters and search boxes to narrow our job results, and we'll also spend a fair bit of time on the responsive design to ensure a great user experience. Let's dive in. So here's our search page. Lovely design. We can see in this section over here, we have our search, select term, and select location. So if I had to search for brand, hit search, we can see that it filters the results. So we have a full-time and a part-time. So if I can select part-time, search again, and then we're down to one result. If I select location, say Los Angeles, this is in San Francisco, we have no results and we have this null data group design down here. And then I can go ahead and reset as well. Now, if I click on one of these cards, so this is basically a repeating group, we have 9 results. If I click on one of these cards, it takes me to the job display page. And this is where someone can actually apply. Now we're going to deal with the application in a later section, but just so you know, you can write a cover letter and you can upload a CV as well. And one more piece of functionality that we can utilize is the ability to bookmark jobs. Now you have to be logged in as a candidate to be able to utilize this feature. Let's have a look at mobile phone widths. Head down to 320. You can see that the text has shrunk in size. This is now stacked in a column layout, and the design here has been adapted very slightly. Okay, so super fun section, a lot of great design work we're going to get stuck into, as well as filtering and displaying. So let's jump into the next lesson.